road there.
Thank you.
One thing that you can't take with you is me, because I'm not continuing anymore. I have to leave when Dondero closes. You will not take me physically, but many of you will take me in your heart, in your pockets, on your back. And you'll also, those of you that are involved in music, you will take Jan Stewart with you. She's going to go, and she's going to be that presence that will help the music department and the choir department be as much of Dondero as Royal Oak High School can take. Take it and love it and make it good. Thank you.
Good day. Bonjour. Buenos dias. Guten Tag. By now, anyone familiar with Dondero has seen this motto at the entrance to the school. Enter here to learn, go forth to serve. Many of you will understand this motto in a language you may have learned here. Entrez ici pour apprendre, partez pour servir. Vengan aquí a aprender y vayan adelante a servir. Kommt hier rein, zu lernen. Geht hinaus, zu dienen. I represent the Foreign Language Department today, and it's an honor to stand here before you on this day, recognizing our Dondero High School. We should be used to it by now, since leaving the insular comfort of home to attend kindergarten, life has been a series of departures. It will always be. It is both easier and harder to leave when we were happy in a familiar place. Dondero has sheltered us in a way that only stately architecture can. The golden bricks inside and out, the honey glow of old wood, the solidity of 1920s walls and doors, the personality of architectural embellishments, the classic murals that reflect a proud history of our community and our state. So it would be easy to think that this building made our high school the cozy place that it has been, but we know that it was more than that. When we leave, like reluctant birds from the nest, we will take the most important part with us, which was the heart and soul we gave to this home away from home. Goodbye and good luck. Au revoir et bonne chance. Adios y buena suerte. Auf Wiedersehen und alles Gute.
And then when the second one arrived in my mailbox, I sent an SOS to my colleagues. They said since I was the department CEO, I'd have to respond ASAP to the call. So I RSVP'd, and now I stand before this last group of Dondero High School students. You may wonder why all the acronyms. Special Ed is notorious for using them. Most people, we think that we speak in a foreign language or in some kind of code. When I say special education, most people picture the obvious, someone who's blind or deaf, or perhaps someone in a wheelchair. Many of you don't really know what it is, nor do most of you know who I am, other than if I removed your hat or asked you to take it off. After doing some research, I found out that the obvious is exactly what special ed started out being. And the first special ed schools were actually for the blind and the deaf, and then they got more into truancy and behavior problems and then for mentally challenged people. It wasn't until 1963 that the term learning disabilities was even used, and now those kind of kids make up the majority of the special ed population. Asperger's syndrome wasn't even recognized until 1994, but then in 1975, with PL 94-142, it was introduced, IDEA, that's when special ed was born. At Dondero, the first special ed classrooms were in the basement. And then there were some that were off of the gym in small areas. Later on, they moved to various places in the building, and room 327, which is now the self-contained special ed classroom, was split into three classrooms, and it had two-way mirrors for observations. When I started at Dondero in 1995, I was the EI teacher. Mrs. Harlan, who works at the front desk, was my parapro. And I have a little history in that classroom. I wanted to tell you a quick story about Mrs. Harlan and I decided to get a classroom pet, so we decided to adopt two rabbits. And so it began. Everything was fine until after Christmas break, and we got back and there was a mess in the back room where we had kept the rabbits, and they had a box that they slept in and took care of themselves, and it was really yucky, so Mrs. Harlan decided to take and get rid of the box, and I said, no problem. And it sat there in the garbage, you know the big garbage bags that we have around now? Well, it sat there for a few days, and one morning I came in early, and there was a little box on my desk, and it had a post-it note on the top, and it said, I found these baby bunnies in the trash. Well, we felt horrible after, you know, we made sure the Humane Society wasn't going to come and get us. There was five baby bunnies in the box. Well, as I said, so it began. When we came back from midwinter break, we had two more. And after Easter break, we had six more. So we ended up having 15 baby bunnies in the classroom. And those bunnies all got adopted by Dondero students. So, but I want to tell you something else. Ever since 1995, when I started in that classroom, the teachers have also all left with at least one baby. So something's going on in there. We also have a classroom in special ed. Oh, put your minds to rest. We have a classroom that is called PAC. You may wonder exactly what happens in PAC. Well, we in special ed are the masters of modification and the aces of accommodation. Once we've done a test for IQ, we have an MET, and then we do an IEP. We make sure that each student gets an FAP in the LRE. A student can be HI, OI, COHI, VI, LD, ADD, ADHD, SMI, CI, AI, EI, EIEIO. I get the idea. Now, general ed is starting to muscle in on our lettering system. Since July 2005, IDEA is now IDEIA. It's improved. Why? Mostly because of NCLB. Teachers are now HQ, and schools have to make AYP and do NCA. You know what, you can come see me, I'll tell you what they all mean. As Dondero closes its door to the historic past, we will all travel north to our OHS. I hope that you will treat each other with TLC and be able to LOL regularly. Remember Dondero as your BFF and enjoy the afternoon. TGIF.
We have a real special treat right now. A lot of you have seen Mr. and Mrs. Rodriguez working in our building this year, capturing the memories of Dondero. In a minute, you're going to see a small piece of a video that they have produced commemorating Dondero. Parts of it are about the building, most of it are about the people, which is obviously the most important part. So take Dondero with you in your hearts, and you will also be able to take some memories of Dondero with this DVD. It will be for sale later on this afternoon, starting at 4 o'clock, and you will also be able to order it starting next week. So here's a small piece of Dondero, and don't forget to keep Dondero in your hearts as well. Thank you.
Great video. Dondero's looking pretty good. We're a team, so we decided to come up here together to do our little presentation this afternoon. Let's say that you were looking for a career that would be interesting and stimulating and enjoyable, where every day you'd be working with impressively professional people, where your clients are always interesting, never boring, and often surprising. That's what our work is like here at Dondero. We've been honored to work with you here at Dondero High School, and we will be honored to work with you at Royal Oak High School as well. First of all, what we're taking to Royal Oak High School are your records and transcripts, so you get all your credits that you've earned. We're also taking your four-year plans and your EDPs, but we're also taking a listening ear, a caring heart,
a soft shoulder,
high expectations for you and for our new school.
Acceptances of differences.
Compassion.
Belief in your ability to succeed.
Support for your efforts to achieve.
Recognition of individual characteristics that make you, you.
Knowledge about college and other post-high school opportunities.
Support for you to accept the things that cannot be changed.
Encouragement for you to change what can be changed.
And help for you to figure out the difference.
An attitude of learning along with you and of serving your needs every day.
And finally, a positive outlook and intention to help Royal Oak High School be the best it can be and to support you in having an excellent learning experience at school and in life. For those of you who don't know who I am, I'm Mrs. Sutton, the school social worker. And what does a school social worker do? I personally think I've got the best job in school because I'm not involved with all those things that go along with changing your schedule, and I don't have to deal with discipline. What my job is to work with you on any issues that interfere with your being successful in school. And I will be at Royal Oak High School in the fall in the Student Services Center.
I just had a couple of words that reflected the other day, Tuesday, when I was at the gym at Kimball last Tuesday. I had the feeling that I had when I was in high school. My high school had 2,000 students. And when we held pep rallies in the gym, that's just what it sounded like. When I first got to Dondero, I was surprised and bemused at how relatively quiet the gym was during whole school events, with half of the number of students or less. At first, I felt bad for the students, not having that sense of bigness, the camaraderie that comes from being part of a really big team. On the other hand, my school was so big, I had felt somewhat intimidated being such a small fish in such a big pond, where I noticed how self-confident the Dondero kids were, knowing that they could be themselves and make a difference. Now the Dondero students have a really unique opportunity to take that sense of self-confidence, that feeling that one person really can make a difference, that knowledge that you are as important as everyone else, and take it with you to a place where some students might feel intimidated by the bigness. You already know that you can make a difference. Having more numbers of students won't change that. In fact, there is much more opportunity to affect change on a greater scale. When we talk about go forth to serve, that's exactly what we mean. Take what you've learned and make the next place the better for it. Like we say, you can take the students from Dondero, but you can't take Dondero from the students.
Good afternoon. I'm Mr. Snyder. By any other name would smell as sweet. And how that quote could be applied to our current situation regarding consolidation and the closing of two high schools and the assimilation into one, I couldn't agree more. Even though there will no longer be a high school at 709 North Washington Avenue in Royal Oak, the spirit of Dondero will be present next year at Royal Oak High School. We've all benefited from working here, teaching here, learning here, and creating relationships here at Dondero. We've benefited from our atmosphere, this as you saw in the video, this caring, this friendly atmosphere, this supportive atmosphere, and the encouraging demeanor that all of you have, that all staff have. We can, and most of us will, take that with us when we go across town to the new high school. If any of you got the senior wills, which was amazing, by the way, the most recent edition of the Acorn senior wills, we'll hopefully read through all of those, as I do. Gary Benson left us with something. I quote him directly. "If you keep just one aspect of Dondero alive at the new high school, make it our friendly and accepting atmosphere. Don't let your bitterness about consolidation prevent you from being the kind and caring people that you are. Rather, let compassion spread throughout the school like an infectious disease." I don't think Mr. Benson thinks of us as a virus. But what I do think is that we should heed his advice. We will be in a new building next year, that's true. But we can take Dondero with us. Now wait a minute, that doesn't mean we need to take everything to Dondero. For instance, we can leave behind the carpet. And we should want to, unless of course you're Mr. Chisnell. We can leave behind the mice. They have plenty over there as well. We can leave behind the crumbling plaster. But you know what, this talk of taking things and not taking things, it reminds me of a quote from a famous American. Richard Nixon once said, with a straight face, I might add, that he was not a crook. Well, with regards to the spirit of Dondero, may we all be crooks. Thank you. ...that I've had and all of my favorite students that I have never had, which is each and every one of you. Looking forward to this day, these events, this closing activities to celebrate just a great building and a wonderful tradition. When your science department got together for this presentation, we asked the question, what would it have been like to be the first science classes at Dondero, then Royal Oak High School, when it first opened? Well, certainly students studied biology, chemistry, and physics, but could they have imagined all of the advances in the life sciences, the physical sciences that were to follow in the passing years and decades? Through the years, students who passed through these halls learned about new discoveries and technologies that would save lives and improve living in ways the first graduates could only dream of. Just think, if you were a student here, you would have not known very much or maybe anything at all about these topics. The polio vaccine, the Human Genome Project, polymers, modern plastics, modern fabrics, nuclear energy. Television had yet to be a practical invention. Refrigerators were called ice boxes, literally. Air conditioning was an open window or an electric fan. Automatic clothes washers were a dream, and a clothes dryer was a line in your yard or basement. Man in space, who would have thought? Air travel was in its infancy. For that matter, so was the automobile. Medical ultrasound and imaging techniques. Throughout the years, students who passed through our science classes learned about new discoveries and technologies that save lives and improve living in ways first graduates could only dream of. Let's take a look at some of the important, and maybe not as important, but interesting technologies and inventions that students at Dondero have learned. Ms. McCobiak, Ms. Elsner, and we have Ms. Quinn. I want to thank everybody, and let's take the spirit and tradition forward. Thank you.
Folks, just give me your attention for a second, please. Well, 2 minutes does not begin to express the depth of feeling that the English department has for you and for this building. We hope we've served you well. We have a little packing themed poem here for you from Emily Dickinson, and like all her poems, of course, it's about death. But it does have metaphors for leaving as well. And it goes like this. Tie the strings to my life, then I'm ready to go. Just to look at the horses, rapid, that will do. Put me in on the firmest side so I shall never fall. For we must ride to judgment, and it's partly downhill. But never I mind the bridges, and never I mind the sea, held fast in everlasting race by my own choice and thee. Goodbye to the life I used to live, and the world I used to know, and kiss the hills for me just once. Now I'm ready to go.
That's a wonderful and moving poem. I can't resist the opportunity to let all of you know what so many of my students do. You can always identify an Emily Dickinson poem by one particular characteristic. It can be sung to a number of theme songs, including one of my favorites, Gilligan's Island. Oh, you doubt me. Tie all the strings to my life, then I'm ready to go. Just a look at the horses, rapid that will do. Put me on the firmest side so I shall never fall. For we must ride to judgment, it's partly down the hill. Never I mind the bridges, never I mind the sea. Hold fast and everlasting race, be my own choice to be. Goodbye to the life I used to live, never life to know. The hills must be just one. So many of our years in the English department describing us by popular words like zesty. But I need to say too, we are the last part of this section of the program, and I wanted to, if I might, wax nostalgic for just a moment. Now, I don't want to get maudlin, but I do want to speak about our department from deep within, from my gut, ears, and eyes. The first thing I want to say is that whatever happens next year, we must, in the words of Long John Silver, always be on your guard, ladies. We must have the principles of an oak, or okay, maybe not that anymore, but of a rock. We can't have any of that crying and wailing. But we must, as said by Conroy, craft our futures. We can, in a word, co-exist with everyone. Right, but those are difficult names. I talked to some of my classes about chi. It's that vibrant force in our lives. And we need to have good chi, because as we all know, bad chi smells. Thank you, Dondero, and thank you, folks.
A CD holder that commemorates Dondero High School.